You know, I wanted to write a novel that was centered around the opioid crisis, you know, and that was very rooted in place in Appalachia, and more specifically in Western North Carolina, where I live. And one of the things that was different from my other novels was that I wanted to tell the story of those affected by addiction rather than the stories of addicts themselves. And so it's largely the story of a father who's trying to hold on to the last bit of family he has, which is a son. And his son is caught in the cyclical nature of opioid addiction. You know, I wrote this novel because the opioid crisis became an inignorable reality of my day-to-day life. You know, every day that I looked out my window, there were addicts walking by on the road. When I went to town to the post office, I would step out and there were needles all over the ground. You know, when I would ride through town, I would see medics bringing bodies from out under bridges or out of the gas station restrooms where people had overdosed and died. And so it became something that was inignorable. And it was also something that was very personal. You know, the first friend I ever lost was a friend named Travis Snipes to a drug overdose, a heroin overdose. And within 6 months, his father died of an overdose. 2 months later, his brother died of an overdose. So that within 8 months, there'd been a father and two sons all died from heroin overdoses. You know, I had a cousin that I lost on New Year's of this year, New Year's Eve party. He went out to his car during a New Year's Eve party, overdosed and died. And so it was very personal, and it was, you know, very real and rooted into that place, and it just became something that I couldn't ignore anymore because it was all around me. You know, I think the end result of climate change is extreme weather patterns. It's the fact that it's snowing outside in Lyon right now. You know, in 2016, I live in a place where we typically get 100 inches of rain a year. Like, it rains almost every day. And in 2016, it didn't rain at all. And so that entire region was just a tinderbox, you know, and so when the fires started in the fall, early fall, you know, they just slowly spread and it went on the rest of the year. It stretched from Alabama to Ohio. And as far as why I wanted to write about that time period with this novel, it was because I had two characters who both believed that they were witnessing the end of the world. And when I thought about what time felt like the end of the world, it was the fall of 2016. And it was because of the fires. You know, you would walk outside and you couldn't even see the sun for the smoke. You couldn't breathe. Everything was burning down all around us. And then the other backdrop of the fall of 2016 was the presidential election where Donald Trump is elected president. And that time period just felt like the end of the world. And so it mimicked the reality of those characters. I think the same thing is true whether we're talking about addiction or whether we're talking about poverty or whether we're talking about violence. There's a cyclical nature to all of that. Patterns seem to get repeated over and over again. You know, and so that's what I'm playing with. You know, I think that the literature mimics the reality of the types of people that I'm writing about. You know, I think about a mother who reached out to me wanting me to help with a charity that she'd started, and she'd lost a son to heroin. And when she told me the stories about her son, she said that every time he would relapse, he would sell his guitar to a pawn shop, and they would give him money for it. And she would always go to the store and buy it back. And she would save it for when he got clean. But the fact was, she would give it to him and he would relapse again. And she did this like 30 times. She bought his guitar, gave it back to him, he relapsed. It happened over and over and over again until finally it didn't ever happen again because he overdosed and died. But so the reality of a lot of the topics that I'm writing about, whether that be poverty or whether that be addiction, is that in America, those things, that's the nature of them. They're cyclical.